Childhood, there probably weren't very many stingrays or penguins in the Arizona desert. That all changed on September 3rd, 2016 when Odysea Aquarium opened its doors. Before we dive into the depths of the Odysea Aquarium, let's take a look at the butterfly wonderland which started it all. One of the first unique experiences for guests is the chrysalis viewing area. This allows guests to observe the most dynamic stage of a butterfly in real time, its metamorphosis.
This is an atlas moth.
The most noticeable part of the butterfly wonderland is called the conservatory, a glass enclosed home to thousands of butterflies from the far reaches of the world.
So right now we're standing in sort of an airlock, and the reason this is like this is so the butterflies don't escape. But on the other side of this door here, we're about to enter the conservatory. A wonderland of over 3,000 butterflies made up of 50 or 60 different species. This is going to be fantastic. Come on.
The Butterfly Wonderland was the first installment in the Odysea in the Desert Entertainment Destination. The Wonderland is the largest indoor butterfly pavilion in America and has plenty to see for guests of all ages. Visitors can walk inside its large glass pavilion, which maintains a simulated tropical rainforest climate for the butterflies. The carefully constructed artificial environment requires a lot of work to maintain, and it's done so by curator Dana Cooper.
We're here at the Butterfly Wonderland, and there are a lot of butterflies. There's this koi pond behind me, and when you walk in, you get this great, just relaxing vibe. There's the Japanese music playing. Dana, tell us more about kind of what's going on here.
All right, well, Butterfly Wonderland is the largest glass enclosed conservatory in the country. As you mentioned, we always have at least 3,000 tropical butterflies flying around in here, and the weather is always lovely and tropical year-round. We import species from all over the world, Asia, Africa, Florida, Central and South America.
Standing here in this environment, the temperature seems kind of unique. Is there a specific reason why we're in such a maybe tropical climate?
Yes, absolutely, and it is a tropical climate. It is designed specifically for the butterflies and the plants. The plants are very important in here as well. They provide habitat and nectar, but we don't have any host plants, so we don't reproduce any of these butterflies. But the climate is always 75 to 80% humidity and degrees year-round.
Now, you mentioned host plants. Why would none of these plants work for breeding butterflies?
That's a very good question. Butterflies are very, what we call, host plant specific. So a female butterfly can detect a host plant by its chemistry, by landing on it and tasting it with her feet. And if it's not a host plant, she won't lay eggs.
So butterflies will only lay their eggs on certain plants.
Exactly.
That's amazing. Isn't nature fun?
That's the common morpho butterfly. I get it from the largest butterfly farm in Costa Rica. The common morpho, when it's at rest and its wings are closed, has a bunch of scary eye spots to keep predators away, because where they're from in Central and South America, birds are their largest predator. But he kind of looks like a scary alien on your shoe right there.
Now, is there anything special about the butterfly landing on me? I heard somebody earlier say that's how butterflies give you kisses.
Well, absolutely. They give you kisses if you're thinking happy thoughts. But also, if you kind of look like another butterfly, which you do because you're wearing blue, or if you look like a flower. So if you're wearing red, yellow, white, lime green, they also really like orange.
Now that we've seen the Butterfly Conservatory, let's go and take a look at the Honeybee Extravaganza.
Loss of habitat has really declined their populations and made it more difficult for beekeepers to keep bees healthy year-round. It really depends on where you're at in the country. For instance, here in the Southwest, we have tons of nectar and pollen all year-round, and the bees do very, very well. I've never had any problem in the 4 years I've been keeping bees here, keeping them healthy. When you go elsewhere to where there's been a lot of habitat destruction, it's really important that beekeepers feed their bees pollen patties and nectar, because the bees don't have the natural forage, which is much better for them anyway, flower nectar and real pollen.
So how does one get involved in becoming a beekeeper? I mean, is it like a family thing? Like, my father was a beekeeper, as was his father, as was my father before. And how do you, like... I mean, essentially, you're trying to keep bees from getting away. Like, I want to keep bees. I don't want to get them away.
Mm-hmm. Well, a lot of beekeepers are family beekeepers. It's actually easy to start doing, but there's a lot to learn about keeping bees. And if you keep them in a box with a queen and it's a healthy environment, they'll stay and they'll do their work. There's a lot to managing them here to keep the grumpy bees at bay that we have in the desert Southwest. But other than that, we have plenty of nectar and pollen, and they do well, and they'll always come back to where their queen is.
Fantastic. This place is so exciting. So not only do we have a butterfly conservatory, but we've got a honeybee extravaganza. And like everyone, who doesn't love honey?
Welcome to Odysea Aquarium, where desert meets ocean. Visit the largest aquarium in the Southwest and ride the only living sea carousel in the world. Your oceanic adventure awaits at Odysea Aquarium in Scottsdale.
I've always had fair and sensitive skin, and I could never find any bath and body products that worked for me. So I decided to start making myself bath and body products that would work on my sensitive skin type. And when I really got into it, I discovered that I really love doing what I do, and I wanted to make a career out of it and help other men and women with the same problems that I have. And that's when Simple Beauty Blends was born. I've always been a really big animal lover, and it's bothered me that big companies use animals to test their products. And that's why I decided when I started my company that I wanted to team up with AAWL and donate a portion of every sale to the charity to help out animals.
Welcome back, guys. We're here with Adi Kanishinsky. I hope I pronounced that correctly. It's one of those names. And you are a member of the family that started this place.
That's right. So I'm the son of Amram Kanishinsky, the founder. And I've been working here with him for a little over 2 years now and working on developing what is this concept. And the idea is creating an entertainment destination, a place that families can come to spend the weekend and enjoy doing something that's not your typical retail center. So everything we do here is alive. So whether it's the aquarium or the butterfly wonderland, we're focusing on not only education, but also entertainment and creating an environment that you want to spend the weekend and you can make great memories.
How do we get to the Odysea Aquarium conceptually, and then from there, where are we going? What's the vision here?
Yeah. So the aquarium was actually an idea that had born almost 20 years ago. My father had built the first for-profit aquarium in the country in Newport, Kentucky, known as the Kentucky Aquarium. And really what happened was he had wanted to build one here in Arizona. And so the concept in its totality is to really build out this entire entertainment district, if you will, beyond just the aquarium, the butterfly, the retail, and the restaurants you see here, which will include our work on a Ferris wheel that'll be behind this center. It would be incredible. You'd get unobstructed views around the entire city. You'd get an opportunity to learn about the community itself during your ride. But it's to go beyond that. So on the next 50 acres that we're working to develop, we're looking into a dinosaur park, so essentially Jurassic Park coming to life. 6 to 7 acres with a lazy river and an indoor dinosaur museum, plus the largest indoor rainforest aviary in the country with 5,000 birds flying freely, a massive 70-foot tree of life in the middle with a treehouse at the top so you can view the canopy of all the different species. You've got all these different monkey species, as well as rivers and waterfalls, and it's an opportunity to really learn more about the rainforests and how they bring life. So again, it's all focused on bringing education but entertainment, mixing the two together. And really with that rainforest aviary, what it's also doing is it's giving people an opportunity to see something they don't get to see in Arizona, let alone the country. And that's really what the Odysea Aquarium is and the butterfly. It's giving children an opportunity to see things that they don't normally get to see.
What do you do when you can't care for your pet anymore and want to make sure it is cared for and loved? You can surrender your pet to the state's oldest and largest no-kill shelter, the Arizona Animal Welfare League. Unlike open intake shelters, your pet is not at risk for euthanization when taken in by the Arizona Animal Welfare League. The owner surrender program is for people who can no longer care for their pets and is by appointment only. Call 602-273-6852 or go to aawl.org for more information.
Bienvenidos a Odysea Aquarium, donde el desierto se une con el mar. Visita el acuario más grande de la región suroeste y súbete al único carrusel marítimo del mundo. Una gran aventura oceánica te espera en Odysea Aquarium.
The first very noticeable feature in Odysea is the series of individually suspended water tanks hanging from the ceiling. Each globe-shaped aquarium is filled with schools of fish and weighs about 1,000 pounds. Sometimes, in the lobby, you'll also get to say hi to Squidney, the two-toed sloth, or other animal ambassadors.
Once you get into the aquarium, it is insane. They have sharks, the bathroom has sharks swimming in the window, the conference rooms have the same thing, and now we're here with Greg, who's the manager, and he's going to explain a little bit more about the aquarium and you know, hopefully how it runs.
Wow, thanks for having us. I really appreciate all your efforts you guys are doing today. But Odysea Aquarium is an amazing experience. We've got 200,000 square feet, 2 million gallons of water, of which we have our shark exhibit right behind us, which is 400,000 gallons. We have over 65 exhibits. We have many world's firsts. We're the only aquarium in the world that has a living sea carousel, which is a 20-minute experience, 4 different rides. We have our aqua lobby that has fish globes hanging from the ceiling. You won't find that anywhere in the world. And behind us right here, we have our martini-shaped exhibit, which is truly, truly unique.
Okay. Yeah, I was wondering what that is. So you said you have over 2 million gallons of water. So the obvious question is, we're in a desert. So first of all, how? And second of all, how long did it take to do that?
Well, you know, it took several months of designing, year and a half of designing, about 18 months to construct. But what's unique is we are in the middle of the desert. So we take water from our city water supply, we treat it through special filters, and then we put in about 23 different kinds of salt, which is a special salt water formula. And then we age that salt water, and then we put it in the exhibit with the animals. And then what goes on behind the scenes to keep these exhibits very clean and healthy for the animals is the filtration, the life support. We've got giant rapid sand filters, protein skimmers. We have all this filtration that cycles the water many times an hour to keep it crystal clear and healthy for all of the animals. This is our shark exhibit. We've got 26 sharks in here. We've got several different species. Sandbars, which are swimming off at the distance. Lemons, which are up high. We have sand tigers. Black tips, which you can see the little bit smaller one.
What are the little things that just went by?
The little fish?
Yeah.
Those are all different jacks. So those are crevel jacks that you can see off in the distance. And then off to the right back there are blue runners and horse-eye jacks.
At the penguin exhibit, guests can observe the playful South African penguins and their agile and graceful swimming patterns through the underwater portholes. In addition, a special PIP, or Penguin Interaction Program, allows visitors to get up close and personal with the happy penguins where photo opportunities are abundant.
Jazzy is an African black-footed penguin, the only species of penguin located in Africa.
Nice, that is fantastic. And she's so playful. She's been nuzzling and nipping away, and that's, she. What is she doing?
She is preening. So these animals are their feathers are very important to them, so they take very good care of them. And one of the ways is preening. They will actually make sure all of those feathers are nice and aligned, because once they get into that water, they need to make sure they're completely waterproof.
So one of the most important questions that I'm sure a lot of our audience has to ask and other people want to know is, what are the conservation efforts that you guys are doing here?
We support SANCOB through our Odysea Foundation. SANCOB is the Southern African Foundation for the Conservation of Coastal Birds, and they not only help rescue, rehabilitate, and release African penguins, but other shorebirds native to South Africa. It's a really great foundation that helps our wild cousins, and we just like to see more numbers in the wild since they are an endangered species.
Penguins are endangered?
Yes, these African penguins are endangered. Their numbers plummeted very low, and SANCOB's actually increased their wild population by about 19% since its founding.
Well, thank you, SANCOB. That's amazing. Why are penguins endangered?
There are quite a few reasons for that. One of the main reasons is climate change and overfishing. So when penguins lay their eggs, both mom and dad both take care of that nest and those chicks once they are hatched out. They do have to go out into the ocean to find their food. So one will stay, one will go out into that ocean. But with climate change and overfishing, they're having to go farther and farther out into that ocean to find that food. Unfortunately then, sometimes the adult does not make it back in time. The other adult will either abandon that nest or the chick does not make it, unfortunately.
So, stop climate change. Stop overfishing. These guys need to eat too. They were kind of here first.
During your descent on an escalator in the encased acrylic tunnel, the escalator to the deep ocean has quite the impressive view. Guests are completely surrounded by eagle rays flying overhead, white-tipped reef sharks emerging from the shadows, rescued sea turtles, and other mesmerizing ocean creatures. Stingray Bay is home to the Underwater Sea Trek exhibit. From atop the platform, any and all guests can watch the underwater ocean adventures and touch marine life such as cow-nose rays, angelfish, and bamboo shark. Those who are more adventurous and also 9 years or older can dive deep with the only indoor sea trek in North America. Participants wear an Odysea wetsuit, a special sea trek helmet, and walk into the water. This experience is an underwater walking adventure that takes participants into a truly immersive experience where they are surrounded by thousands of sea creatures from the Indo-Pacific region of the world. Odysea Aquarium provides wetsuits for guests to change into, as well as lockers, towels, and a hot shower to rinse off. We would recommend bringing your own swimsuit to wear underneath the wetsuit. It is not necessary to be scuba certified, but reservations are required. Guests get their own underwater cameras to capture this once-in-a-lifetime experience, and the safety divers who are scuba certified may even teach you a few fun tricks. On your way out, make sure to stop by the Living Sea Carousel. It is considered to be an engineering marvel and is the very first of its kind. All from the comfort of a theater-style seat, visitors are whisked away on a voyage through the Living Sea for a 20-minute thrilling experience, which includes real-time question and answer with the diver.
All right, guys, so we're about to do a Q&A here with the diver. You'll see it in just a second. She's actually going to be underwater. The curtain's going to come back, and we'll do a quick session with her.
Hi, Jess. How are you?
Good. How are you guys doing?
Great. So tell me what's going on here.
Yeah, so you guys are looking at our open ocean exhibit. A little bit different than a lot of the areas you guys have seen today. You just came from a lot of really pretty, re-swelling, colorful fish. And in here we have a lot of silverfish and kind of toned down animals.
Now, who's this big guy?
That is our Queensley grouper. And she's the largest animal on this exhibit. She's about 200 pounds right now. Not full grown. They actually can be over 800 pounds over 9 feet long, fully grown.
Wow. So out of all of the fish in here, who's your favorite?
Oh man, that's really tough. I really like the tarpon. That's kind of this long, silver, torpedo-shaped fish. And they actually grow to be about 6 to 8 feet long, about 250 pounds, so they'll be human size someday.
Wow.
But they have a really neat ability. They can go up to the surface and actually pull air from the surface and get oxygen that way, which is pretty unique in the ocean.
That's crazy. Now, I see you have two stingrays floating around in here as well.
I do. These are called flying grass stingrays. They're both female, both full grown. The one that just went by me, she's about 100 pounds.
Wow. That's great. So if people want to come and they want to do the carousel exhibit, they want to sit in here and find out more about all the marine life, how can they find out more or buy tickets?
Well, we always get the opportunity to ask questions. So if there's a particular animal in here that somebody wants to
All right, well, thank you so much.
Yeah, absolutely. Thank you, guys. I hope you enjoyed your visit.
Oh, we definitely will.
All right,
thank you.
Bye.
Oh, my gosh. I'm frozen. Are you frozen?
I took a hot shower.
I'm pretty cold.
Did you guys not know about the hot showers? You turn it to hot, they have soap right there. I didn't even think about it. It's like a hotel.
I just wanted to get out of that wetsuit.
Yeah.
I expected the wetsuit to just peel off like in the movies.
It was so hard to get off.
You should have seen me. I'm like going like this and trying to find it. And then they got a string. You just pull the string and it's so easy.
Mine didn't have a string on it. I had to have the lady unzip me.
I was like,
hey, why don't you unzip me?
Well, it was really fun. I learned so much about everything. Well, marine life, butterflies.
You know, the people who work here, they're not just people who are working a job. They're really knowledgeable. They love what they do. One of our guides let us know that she's dived in every tank here, swam with all of the animals here. They know their stuff.
I was surprised at how well taken care of the animals are because it's so obvious when you go down there, they don't shy away from you. There was that whole swarm of fish that came up and surrounded us, and they're not scared of people. They're happy, they're well fed.
Well, that's one of the things that's important to take care of. It's important that we know because a lot of people say, well, what are they, you know, what's going on with the animals? Are they taking care of them?
A lot of people don't want to come to places like this because they think the animals are treated really bad, but they're not here.
If this was a movie, we could put no animals are harmed.
Yeah.
At the very end of the credits. So come out. Check out the Butterfly Wonderland. Check out the Mirror Maze. Check out the Carousel. Check out all of it. You will not regret it. I don't think, personally, I think this is the best thing we've ever done.
Yeah.
It's definitely, you can definitely make a day out of this. So thank you guys so much for tuning in. We're going to go have a lot more fun and then check out some more marine life. So we'll see you guys next time on the Talk Around Town Show.